been here for 24 months. It's the authority to determine what length of time a person has to be here in order to be subjected to expedited removal.
Here's what the statute said. The Attorney General, which is actually the DHS Secretary, may apply clauses 1 and 2 of this subparagraph to any and all aliens described in subclass 2 as designated by the Attorney General, actually DHS. Such designation shall be in the sole and unreviewable discretion of the Attorney General and may be modified at any time. Now, I've been in this business for quite a while. What the Trump administration did was to use the discretion given to it by statute in a way different than prior administrations. This advocacy group, the Arabella supported advocacy group, tried to strike it down. You rule for them. Here's what the D.C. Circuit Court said about your ruling. There could hardly be a more definitive expression of congressional intent to leave the decision about the scope of expanded removal within statutory bounds to the Secretary's independent judgment. The forceful phrase, sole and unreviewable discretion, buys exceptional terms. Such designation shall be in the sole and unreviewable discretion of the Attorney General and may be modified at any time. For those of us in the law writing business, I don't know how you could tell a judge more clearly that the administration, the agency in question, has discretion to do certain things within the statute. So this is an example to me, and you may not agree, where the plain language of the statute was completely wiped out by you. You reached a conclusion because you disagreed with the Trump administration, and the D.C. Circuit Court of Appeals said, as I quoted just a minute ago, there could hardly be a more definitive expression of congressional intent to leave the decision about the scope of expedited removal within the statutory bounds to the Secretary's independent judgment. That, to me, is Exhibit A of activism. Let's go back to the child pornography cases.
Senator, would you allow me to...
Yes, please.
Thank you. The statute and the circumstances that you reference are accurate insofar as that is what the statute says. It's not all of it. It doesn't describe the designation process that I was trying to articulate. And it doesn't address the fact that Congress has another statute that is presumptively applied in agency cases to tell agencies how to exercise discretion. There's also D.C. Circuit case law that says that in addition to having that procedural statute be presumptive, even very clear designations of authority to an agency may still